हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल एजुकेशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन। टुडे इज 22 मार्च एंड हियर वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द 15 करंट अफेयर क्वेश्चंस विथ एक्सप्लेनेशन इन दिस वीडियो। सो दोज हु आर न्यू ऑन आवर चैनल, प्लीज लाइक सब्सक्राइब एंड शेयर द कंटेंट। सो लेट स्टार्ट विदाउट द डिले। द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज When is World Poetry Day celebrated? When is World Poetry Day celebrated? The correct option is option B, 21st March. Held every year on 21st March, World Poetry Day celebrates one of the humanity's most treasured forms of cultural and linguistic expression on an identity. Practiced throughout history, in every culture and on every continent, poetry speaks to our common humanity and our shared values, transforming the simplest of poems into a powerful catalyst for dialogue and peace. So next question is, according to the recent report, which country has the most dangerous roads in the world? According to the recent report, which country has the most dangerous roads in the world? Correct option is option C, South Africa. South Africa has been ranked as the world's most dangerous countries to drive in India, while India came in at fourth place. According to a research study undertaken by international driver education company Zootopia. Next question is, who has been elected as the Sarkhya or General Secretary of Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh RSS? Correct option is option B, Dattatreya Hosawal. Dattatreya Hosawal, known as Dattaji in RSS, has become the new Sarkariya General Secretary of the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangh RSS. He has been placed. Bhaiyaji Joshi, 65-year-old Hosawal, was elected at RSS Akhil Bhartiya Pratinidhi Sabha, the highest decision-making body of RSS, held in Bengaluru on March 20. Sarkhya Joint Secretary of RSS since 2019. He will be Sarkhya of RSS for the term of 3 years. The election to the post of Sarkariya take place once in 3 years. The correct option is option B, Dattatreya Hosawal. Next question is, which state has recently merged as a model state for One Dhan Vikas Yojana? One Dhan Vikas Yojana. Correct option is option C, Manipur. One Dhan Vikas Yojana is a program for value editing, branding and marketing of minor forest produces by establishing One Dhan Kendras to facilitate creation of a sustainable livelihoods for the forest-based tribes. One major scheme that the contributed to increase employment and income generation among the tribal population is a One Dhan Tribal Starter Program, a component of the Mechanism for the Marketing of Minor Forest Produce MFP through Minimum Support Price MSP and Development of Value Chain for MFP schemes. Since its inspection at the nodal agency working in the area of tribal upliftment, TriFeed has been implementing several programs and initiatives. The focus of this initiative is to make India self-reliant under the Atmanirbhar Abhiyan with the motto, Go Vocal for Local, Go Tribal, Mera One, Mera Dhan, Mera Udyam. So correct option is option C, Manipur. Next question is, recently with which country has India launched artificial intelligence initiative? So correct option is option B, USA. The Indo-US Science and Technology Forum, IUSSTF, has launched the US-India Artificial Intelligence Initiative to focus on AI cooperation in critical areas that are priorities for both countries, the Department of Science and Technology. So correct option is option B, USA. Next question is, according to the recent report, by what percent the SBI's digital transactions increased? The correct option is option B, 7%. The country's largest lender, State Bank of India, has seen a perceptible increase in the number of transactions happening at its multiple digital channels, with the percentage moving from 60% to 67% currently. Chairman Dinesh Khara said. Who is the chairman of SBI? Dinesh Khara. Next question is, according to a recent report, which is the only Asian currency strength? The correct option is option C, rupee. India's rupee is the only currency in Asia to strength amid this month's rout in risk assets, thanks to a spree of share sale offers that are luring foreign investors. So correct option is option C, rupee. Rupee is the strength Asian currency. Next question is, which state government has announced to give additional salary of the month to health workers? So correct option is option B, Jharkhand. The Jharkhand government has decided to hike the pay for midday meal kitchen assistants at government schools by 500. Following the hike, 79,551 kitchen assistants in the state would get 2,000 per head each month for the work. The hike will be effective from April 1st, 2021. Next question is, who has recently launched the VoiceChat 2.0 features? Correct option is option C, Telegram. So Telegram is an Indian company. Telegram launches VoiceChats 2.0 for unlimited participants in channels. In a recent update, Telegram Messenger introduced VoiceChats 2.0 with rich features for conducting live voice chat sessions in channels for unlimited participants in a secured and seamless manner. So correct option is option C, Telegram. Next question is, which state has announced the launch of summer campaign? Correct option is option B, Jharkhand. The Jharkhand government Wednesday announced the launch of summer strategies action for alleviation of malnutrition and anemia reduction campaign to tackle malnutrition in the state. So correct option is option B, Jharkhand. Next question is, recently Arindam Bagchi has been appointed as the spokesperson of which ministry? So correct option is option C, Foreign Ministry. Arindam Bagchi, an officer of the 1995 batch of the Indian Foreign Service IFS, was named the next spokesperson of the External Affairs Ministry as part of a reshuffle. People familiar with developments said on condition of anonymity. Correct option is option C. Arindam Bagchi has been appointed as the spokesperson of Foreign Ministry. Next question is, which country had recently enacted a law legalizing euthanasia? Correct option is option B, Spain. Spain's lower house of parliament approved the law with support from center and left-wing parties on Thursday. The law allows adults with serious and incurable disease that cause unbearable suffering to choose to end their lives. It is expected to take effect in June. Before the law's pass, helping someone to die in Spain was potentially punishable by a jail term of up to 10 years. Today, we have become a country that is more human, fairer and freer, Spanish Prime Minister Pedro Sanchez tweeted just minutes after the vote. The euthanasia law, widely demanded by society, has finally become a reality. So correct option is option B, Spain. Next question is, which medal has been won by India's Yashaswini Deshwal in ISSF World Cup recently? Correct option is option C, gold. The Indian women and men's team won gold medal in the 10 meter air pistol event on Sunday at the ongoing ISSF World Cup being held in New Delhi. The India's women team of Manu Bhakar, Ashwini Singh Deswal and Sri Nivita Paramananthan beat their Polish opponents with relative ease to secure the gold medal. So correct option is option C, gold. Next question is, where has India's participated the recent Nowruz festival? Correct option is option B, Beijing. India participated in the Nowruz festivities at the SCO Secretariat in Beijing on Friday. Indian pavilion set up by India Tourism Office, Beijing was the center of attraction for many as it showcased its cultural diversity, cuisine and heritage. So correct option is option B, Beijing. Next question is, who has launched the Sahi Disha campaign? Correct option is option A, UNDP. The UNDP has launched Sahi Disha campaign to celebrate women's livelihoods and entrepreneurship in rural India. Next question. So this is the question I have asked in the last video. The question was, where was the mission Gramoday been launched recently? Correct option is option C, Madhya Pradesh. This question is already discussed in the previous video. So again, I am discussing here. In Madhya Pradesh, Union Agricultural Minister Narendra Singh Tomar and Chief Minister Shivraj Singh Chauhan have launched the mission Gramodaya in the state. So this question has been for you. You have to give the answer in the comment section box. The question is, according to the recently released World Happiness Report, which has become the happiest country in the world? So you should have to give the answer in the comment section box, and I will give you the answer of this question of the current affair video of 23rd March 2021. So thank you everyone. Those who are new on our channel, please like, subscribe and share the content. Thank you.